My name is Vladislav Inozemtsev. I'm from Russian Federation, and I'm the founder and chairperson of a not very big foundation, which is called the Center for Post-Industrial Research in Moscow. We are specializing in exploring technological changes in the contemporary world, as well as different economic problems which are connected with globalization. If to put all the attention for one major challenge, I should say that the biggest problem for my country, for Russian Federation, is, from my point of view, is to tackle the difference between economic globalization, in which Russia is heavily involved in, and political short-mindedness, because Russia, till now, the Russian political and expert elite, till now considers Russia as one of the global or international superpowers or great powers, which can manage their problems a little bit not depending from the outside world. So the discussion in the Russian politics and the Russian worldview is rather based on nation-state values. In the age of globalization, I think it's a big problem, because if Russia faces some economic difficulties, some political problems, every time the Russian political elite and the Russian intellectual elite wants to blame the outside factors, the United States, the globalization, the processes which are evolving in the world, for these difficulties and some problems. I think this particular point should be overcome in the years to come if Russia wants to join definitely this globalized world of today. As I told before, I see the major challenge for Russia, some gap between the globalization in which Russia is involved economically and a little bit also in social policy, and the political worldview of Russians, which looks on their country as a nation state acting as if there is no globalized world around. I think that this may be overcome on the base of more profound and deep integration and interrelation between, first of all, Russia and Europe, because Russia is a part of European civilization. Economically, Russia is highly dependent from Europe, and Europe is also somehow dependent from Russia in its oil and gas supplies. Culturally, Russian-European ties are also very, very deep and profound. So I think that accepting globalization for the Russian people, for the Russian elite, should be equal to accepting European values and to become closer and more friendly towards Europe. Of course, this task needs also a change in the European approach towards Russia. I hope that in coming years or decades, the European leadership will consider Russia as an integral part of Europe, and the interrelationship and even integration between Russia and Europe will go forward. Definitely, I think that cooperation between Russia and Europe, not only in economic affairs, which we can witness now, but as well in social policy cohesion, in deepening social and human context with Russia and Europe, it's of very big importance for Russian Federation. I think also that it would be very productive for Russia to adopt some parts, maybe the whole European judicial agenda, because I think that what we have witnessed in Russia for last 10 or 15 years is that Russia cannot establish itself from outside as a real law-abiding country. I think a European factor may be of great importance this way. You know, this question should be divided into a personal one and into a general one. For myself, as somebody who belongs to the middle estate in Russia and who was engaged in business and who can now freely travel the world, buying books, making his, my research and so on, meeting interesting people, inviting them to Russia. I'm living in a globalized world like most European Steve. But for a majority of Russians, I think it's only hope to live in such a world. And I think if in coming years Russia will succeed in promoting more political liberties, in promoting more political openness and open-mindedness, it will be a very good thing for the majority of Russian people. I do believe that globalization is mostly a good thing for all the nations involved, if their government, if their governments deal with the globalization issues properly. I am sure we can. We will see some profound changes. I think these changes will not happen in the global architecture of the world. I don't see, as someone suggests, that the United States may fall out from the global leadership. I don't think that China will overtake the United States or Europe as a global superpower. But definitely I can imagine that the ties between Russia and the European Union will intensify, and so maybe even Russia will be a part of the European Union or some other European economic and political structure in 20-30 years from now. I also can imagine that it will be a huge breakthrough in ecological politics in the world, because I'm not sure that the problem of global warming is the biggest now, but I'm definitely sure that the problem of ecology as well, deforestation, lack of water, of clean air and so on, is of very big importance. So I think the resolving of some ecological problems may be the second biggest breakthrough I can imagine.